Hello commanders, welcome back. Today we are gonna take a look at another multi-role ship. This time is the Adder, which can be considered as the baby cobra or the Sidewinder's biggest brother, and this is because it can perform very easily each and every one activity in the game. The cost of the Adder is at around 87.8k credits, and it comes with some nice speed. It's not very slow, not very fast either, but it has one of the best maneuverabilities in the game. The defenses of the Adder are nothing spectacular, its shields are very weak, but it has some strong, decent armor that will help you survive. And if we combine this with the fact that the Adder comes with 3 hard points, 1 medium and 2 small, that means that this ship can be used effectively at bounty hunting. With its stock equipment, the Adder has 8 available power, only 6 tons of cargo capacity and a jump range of 9.12 light years and 8.47 light years laden. The jump range is quite promising, and when this ship was introduced in the game, quite some emphasis was given at its exploration capabilities, so we will have to come back to the jump range and see how far we can make the Adder jump and if it's a suitable ship for exploration. Before doing that though, like with any other ship, we are going to replace all the basic modules with the best available option and see how good the stats of the Adder can be. So with the best available modules, the Adder has now 12 available power and its jump range has increased to 21.57 light years, which is quite nice, and it might be a nice exploration ship. We're gonna check this later, as I said. Its laden jump range is at 19.90, but only with 6 tons cargo capacity. This jump range is going to drop though as soon as we add some more cargo racks, and this is exactly what we are going to do now. With only cargo racks equipped, our little Adder can achieve a maximum cargo capacity of 26 tons, and that is better than the hauler actually, slightly better but still better, which means that the Adder is the best trading ship before the Cobra, and if you are looking for a nice trading ship in order to make enough credits and proceed to the next ship of your choice, then the Adder can be a solid option. By equipping the best available shield generator, the Adder now can have the best protection and a cargo capacity of 18 tons, which is not bad at all. But if we downgrade our shield generator, we can still have some protection and 22 tons of cargo capacity, so the Adder looks very good even with the lowest available shield generator, the lowest class of shield generator. And what is very interesting is that laden jump rage at 17.33 light years, which might be that the Adder is also suitable for some rare goods trading. I'm gonna remove the shield generator and I'm going to add a fuel scoop. In that way, our cargo capacity is at 24 tons, which is quite good for transferring around rares, and 17.43 jump rate laden. We can increase this a bit by removing the pulse lasers that the Adder has when you buy it. And now our jump rate, our laden jump rate, has increased to 18.25 light years, which is incredible, very good. You can transfer around rare goods and make enough profit very fast. It is an excellent ship, not for normal trading, but also for rare goods trading. Of course, it is up to you if you want to go out like this or add a shield generator. If you do want to have a shield generator, you are gonna have a cargo capacity of 20 tons and a laden jump range of 18.58 light years, but you are gonna have some protection as well, so it's up to you. And if we remove this fuel tank and replace it with a fuel tank with less capacity, we can see that our jump rate is increasing even further. With a capacity of 4, our jump rate, landing jump rate, goes up to 19.53, and with a capacity of 2, our jump rate is going up to 20.03 light years. This is an excellent trading ship, both for normal trading and rare goods trading. Let's go ahead and take a look at its mining capabilities. It has a lot of modules to have enough cargo and a refinery. If we replace here the fuel scoop with a refinery, we can have a shield, 20 tons of cargo capacity, and a refinery with maximum up to 4 bins. And of course, we can remove the shield generator for 4 extra capacity, so our cargo capacity can go up to 24 tons. This is quite good, and of course, we're gonna need some mining lasers. The Adder comes with 3 hard points, 1 medium and 2 small, which means that you can make a combination of offensive modules, offensive weapons, and mining lasers, so you can mine with some extra protection, some ability to defend yourself in case someone try to attack you, so you can have one mini laser at the medium hard point and two weapons of your choice at the small hard point. They can be either lasers or multi-cannons or whatever else you prefer, or you can have two mini lasers at the small hard points and one strong weapon at the medium hard point. In that way you can make enough credits from mining and be protected at the same time. Let's go back though to the others very good jump range and see if we can make it any better. In order to do this, we are gonna replace all these modules or the basic modules with their latest version, and of course we're gonna leave the frameshift drive as it is. Let's go ahead and take a look. And we have achieved a jump range of 27.30 light years and 19.65 light years landing, and with this specific setup with no weapons and utility mounts, only the modules that you see at the moment, we can make some rare goods trading in a better way than before. And of course the other is perfect for exploration. It has some really good jump range. 27.3 light years is more than enough. Of course, if we want to go out for exploration, we will have to remove these cargo racks and add some more exploration specific tools, some more exploration specific modules like scanners. Let's go ahead and see how our adder will look. And this is what our little adder will look like if we equip it for exploration duties. It has enough modules to carry an advanced or intermediate or basic discovery scanner, whatever you prefer, a shield generator for some protection, detailed surface scanner, which is very important at every exploration ship, a fuel scoop, because you are going to need a fuel scoop if you are out there in deep space, there are no stations there, and even if you are in a populated area, it's good to have a fuel scoop to save money from refueling at stations, and of course a very important module again for each exploration ship, the autofill maintenance unit. A very nice choice for exploration. The only thing I don't like about the adder being an explorer is the fact that you have to equip it with some very expensive modules like the advanced or the intermediate discovery scanner and a detailed surface scanner. The cost of the hull itself is very low, less than 100k credits, so if you are going to equip it with modules that cost 500k credits or 1.5 million credits, or even the detailed surface scanner that costs around 250k credits, well, that's quite a risk. Of course, if you insist on taking the adder out for exploration, I'm afraid you have to equip these expensive modules, the advanced or the intermediate discovery scanner, and this is because the view from the cockpit is really bad and you won't be able to do some proper exploration by combining a basic discovery scanner and observation. On the other hand, the view inside the adder, the cockpit, it's quite amazing. It's a really beautiful ship, and we can see here the second seat for a pilot, a co-pilot, and this is a better view from the interior of the ship. It will be quite nice to have someone sitting over there. It will feel like we're not alone when we're out in space doing our thing. What about fighting though? The fact that the adder comes with some really nice hard points and one of the best maneuverables in the game, it makes it look quite promising. Let's go ahead and adjust our setup in order to make it more suitable for combat roles. And this is what the combat loadout will look for the adder. I have placed the best options for thrusters and power distributor, and this is quite important because we want to achieve the best speed, the best possible speed, and of course we can go and downgrade our frameshift drive from the A3 to its latest version, which is the D3. And you can see now that our mass has slightly decreased, which will have a positive impact on our top speed. Of course the adder has a lot of modules. I have only used 3 of them. It has 2 more available. You can put whatever you want in there. With this loadout, with this specific loadout, we can have the best shield available for the adder, and 2 shield cell banks, 1B3 and 1B2. We can now carry 19 shield cells, which is quite good. Of course you can remove them and place more A's. It is up to you, it's your choice actually. And now let's talk about the hard points. We have already mentioned that the adder comes with 3 hard points, 1 medium and 2 small hard points, and this is providing us with the opportunity to make as many combinations of weapons we want. We can add a laser on the medium hard point to take down shields fast, and 2 multi-cannons on the small hard point, or we can go with 3 lasers to save money from ammunition, or we can go even with 3 multi-cannons to take down hulls of our enemies fast. In this case I will go with 3 lasers. I will place a burst laser on the medium hard point and 2 pulse lasers on the 2 small hard points. This is a quite nice setup if you want to save money from ammunition, and it will be quite effective against the shield of your enemies. All we have to do is test it, but before we can go out there, we should put something on the utility mounts. The adder has two utility mounts. We can as well place a combination of everything we want: a point defense, a chaff launcher, a heat sink. I'm gonna go with the chaff launcher. And I'm gonna place at the second utility mount a heatsink in case we're gonna have some problem with the three lasers. So there you go, we are ready to go out there and use our little ladder for bounty hunting. I'm really curious to see how effective it will be. But before we go out there and find enemies to kill, let's do a little test on our speed. How fast we can go with our current setup, which is not the lightest. Our maximum speed can go up to 238, which is not that bad, not the best of course, and if we boost we can achieve a nice speed of 342. It's not that bad. It could be better if we focus on making it a bit lighter, but it will be enough for now. So let's go ahead and find some enemies to kill and make some profit from bounty hunting. Let's go after that wounded viper. Let's put some repair on weapons and let's take it down. We have better maneuverability than the Viper, so it won't be a problem. Of course, the Viper has better weapons, two medium hardpoints and two small, while we have only one medium hardpoint and two small. And of course, the Viper is faster. That means that if that dude decides to leave, then we can follow him.
Flight assist on.
Okay, let's get back in there. Use chaff and try to take him down.
Flight assist off. Flight assist on. Flight assist
off. Flight assist on. Let's put some more power on weapons. Because of our better maneuverability, it's easy to stay behind it and take the advantage in the fight. But like I said, we can follow it if it decides to leave the battlefield. I think this is what it's doing at the moment. Others have joined as well. Let's try to finish it fast. And NPCs always are doing that thing. Passing in front of you when you are fighting someone.
Flight assist on.
It's dead. There you go.
Flight assist.
And a dangerous cobra. Let's go after that and see how we can do against a better enemy. Of course, we have to take down the shields fast. As fast as possible. Is he trying to escape? No, he's coming back. Our lasers are out of juice, so we have to wait for them to recharge. This is the only drawback for having a full laser loadout. Ooh, and this is scary. Let's get out of his way. Use a chaff just in case. And get back in there. Where is he?
Flight assist off.
There he's coming for me.
Flight assist on. Flight assist off. Target shields online. Flight assist on.
Okay, he has others attacking him as well. That's good.
Target shields offline.
His shields are down again. Our two weapons, of course, and now that we are really close, we can attack him with our burst laser on our medium hard point. This is doing a lot of damage. And we have to be careful to land our hits, at least with the medium hard point. Stay close to him. Again, our maneuverability is helping us. Same with the Viper before. We can use this in our advantage.
Target shields online.
His shields are back up. He's a brave NPC. He's not leaving. Nice move. He seems to be mad at me for attacking him. Okay.
Shields offline.
Ooh.
Critical.
Damn, that can happen. So this is why you should avoiding crashes. Now let's get back into station. At least we got the bounty.
Cabin,
it's quite scary when it happens, I'm gonna be honest.
Scan detected.
And we made it back in time. We survived that awful crash with that Cobra. The other can perform quite well in combat, as we have seen, with the combination of the 3 hard points, 1 medium and 2 small hard points, and of course one of the best maneuverabilities in the game. Can help it take down very strong enemies. The only drawback the other has in combat is the placement of the hard points. The medium hard point is placed on top of the other, while the two small hard points are placed underneath the hull, and this is making it a bit difficult to hit with all three weapons at the same time in certain situations. This is easily fixed if we place some gimbaled weapons, or we can just assign them in different fire groups and fire with them separately. Other than that, the Adder is a very nice choice for bounty hunting. Also, because the Adder has a lot of modules available, a lot of slots available, we can equip there some cargo racks. And we can go out there like this with a cargo capacity of 14 drones, 1 shield a bank, best shield available. Of course, you can play with the cargo racks, create any combinations you like, and perform as a pirating vessel. It is a really nice starting ship to do some piracy and see if you enjoy this certain activity of the game. And of course, you are gonna also need a cargo scanner upon the utility mounts. This is a very nice ship. It will give you the opportunity to test each one activity in the game and see which one suits your playstyle best. And when you are ready, you can do the jump to a Cobra. This was the Adder, a very nice and very useful ship. Thank you very much for joining me watching this video. I'm Squid of Love, fly safe commanders, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.